Hare Krishna. The mind doesn't know what it wants and is ready to fight against the world to get it. Normally, if we want something very strongly, we are ready to fight against the whole world. At all costs, I'll get it. But suppose somebody fights against the whole world to get something, and then they get it, and they discard it and go to something else. Say, what is this? If you didn't value it at all, why did you fight so much for it? Sometimes children are like that. They cry and create a big tantrum. They just bring the whole house down with their crying, demanding a toy. And finally, if the parents give the toy to the child plays it for this for some time and just discards the toy. And then doesn't even notice it for months and years together. And the parents get exasperated. No, you made such a show about wanting that toy. You create such a hue and cry. And we worked hard to get it and now you're neglecting it. So then the parents also have to become mature that they don't take the child's tantrums too seriously. Our mind is like such a child. It just gets infatuated by whatever catches its fancy. It's like a child. In the Bhagavad Gita, in the 6th chapter, Krishna says in 34th, Arjuna says in 34th verse, Chanchalam himanah Krishna pramathi balavadrudham tasyaham nigraham manye vayorivasudushkaram. He says that the mind is restless, chanchala. You can say this is like a child. Children are also restless, but chanchalam himanah Krishna pramathi, it's mad. And it's not just mad, balavad, it's extremely powerful. And not just powerful, drudham, it's obstinate. Once it gets some idea into its head, catches some idea, it just doesn't let go. So in that sense, the mind is like a very obstinate and very strong child. So when something catches its fancy, it may just not let us think of anything else. I want this and I want this right now. It may disrupt our whole life. Hey, somebody's an alcoholic and that person is, you know, doing some work, responsible work at home, in the office, or taking care of some family responsibility at home, doing some spiritual practices. And suddenly the mind says, I want a drink. And the mind can become so insistent that the person just drops everything and goes to get a drink. And then they drink a little bit and tell them, hey, this doesn't taste all that good. Let's get something else. So we can look back at our own lives and see there's something which we craved for a lot. We struggled against the whole world to get it. And after getting it, we found that it was anticlimax. It didn't really bring much of the fulfillment, the enjoyment that we hoped for, that was touted. So if we consider such experiences seriously, then we will stop taking our mind too seriously. What the mind actually wants is Krishna. Because whatever is attractive in this world, whatever catches the mind's fancy, that thing gets its attractiveness from Krishna. In 10.41 in the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Yad yad vibhuti mat sattvam, shri madurjitam eva va, tattadevava gachatvam, mama tejoamsha sambhava. Says, whatever is attractive in this world manifests a spark of Krishna's attractiveness. So, by understanding this wisdom from the Bhagavad Gita, we can become fixed in pursuing Krishna. Not pursuing whatever the mind starts craving. And as we start experiencing Krishna, our mind will realize that Krishna is so relishable that it is Krishna that is longing for. And then maya sakta manaha, our mind will become attached to Krishna, absorbed in Krishna, and then we will find lasting, uninterrupted, supreme satisfaction. Thank you. Hare Krishna.